the registers of the firm, the partner, or the member in his individual capacity is the shareholder, then in such a case, an advance or loan made to the firm, the association of persons, or the Hindu undivided family cannot be termed as advance to the partner or the member. Further, the language is unhappy in other respects also. In the case of payment to a shareholder, unless it is an advance or loan, it cannot be treated as a distribution of dividend to him, while where the payment is on behalf of or for the individual benefit of any such shareholder. Lastly, I come to clause 271. No person shall be qualified to represent an assessee in case in his own assessment a penalty has been imposed for concealing the particulars of his income or deliberately furnishing inaccurate particulars of his income. Does this suggestion apply to legal practitioners and advocates appearing on behalf of an assessee? This is a very moot point. From this angle, the class of legal practitioners are agitated. In the case of advocates whose conduct is governed by the Bar Counsel's Act will be matter related to his own assessment debar him from carrying on his profession. It may be that in a particular case the income tax officer wrongly holds that the advocate is guilty of concealing the particulars of his income, deliberately furnishing inaccurate particulars of such income, and a penalty is imposed. Immediately such an order is passed, the advocate will be debarred from practicing or representing an assessee if otherwise qualified to appear in other cases. Why debar him from appearing in cases of the assessee? Further, this other imposing penalty may be taken to be a finding of misconduct on the part of the advocate, and a question may be arise whether he would be debarred from carrying on his profession altogether. This suggestion of the Select Committee needs reconsideration, and in many opinion the clause ends suitable change. The legal profession should be protected and they should be allowed to represent the assessees, even though there might be complaints against their assessment of incomes. With these few suggestions, I again commend this bill and would like to congratulate the Select Committee for the hard labor that they have put in and bringing the bill in a presentable form.